Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yes, now you can mute. I can hear some other voices in between. So you can mute now. Now, last class we have seen different chords. Still, many of you are having the muted. Okay, last class we have seen different types of ports of computer. So, Donna, tell me, what are the different types of ports?
Modem port, Ethernet port.
Very good, yes.
USB port.
Yes.
Then serial port.
Yes.
Then parallel port.
Okay. The rest, Shivani.
Man power connector. Man power connector. Fire wire port.
Can you keep them? You can see a mic, that wire. That side, can you keep it like this? Yes.
Man fire wire port.
Okay.
Power connector.
Yes.
Ethernet port. USB port.
Yes.
Then parallel port.
Yes, yes, correct. Gauri. Can you tell me the full form of USB port?
Universal serial bus.
Universal serial bus. Very good. So hope you understood. Any doubt regarding that ports? So you need ports. Why you need ports? Why we studied about ports? Simply, since it is there in your syllabus. Why you studied, Vidur? What is a port? What is the use of that?
I'm to connect external devices.
Yes, external devices. Very good. Adul, Hadi, Amal, switch on your video. So now in this class, we are going to see what are the different units of memory. You know what is memory, right? What is computer memory? Why we need memory? Emmanuel, why we need memory in computer?
We need memory to store things and reply.
Okay. What is a normal RAM space, memory space, RAM?
2, 4, 6.
2, 4. Only just number is enough. 2, 4. What is that? After that?
RAM.
What? Okay. After 2, 4?
GB.
There is, yes, GB. A giga, full form is giga.
Byte.
Byte. What is that? Gigabyte. You have any idea, Emmanuel?
Yes.
Yes.
Then gigabyte. 1024 MB.
Then what is 1024 MP?
1024 KB.
What is 1024 KB?
Achut achut.
Achut. 1024 KB.
1024 bytes.
Then byte. 1 byte is equal to.
Tigalayalam.
Who's telling? 1 byte is equal to?
No idea.
So we'll be seeing what is that memory. So whether it is hard disk memory, whether it is RAM memory, ROM memory, then we will use a unit. Like for weight, you use gram, kilograms. For distance, you use meter, kilometer. The same way, for memory space, we use byte. Byte as a unit. Okay, so we have different types of. Okay, the different units of memory. So the smallest unit, like you'll say at an element, the smallest unit is atom. The same way, the smallest unit in memory is called a bit. What is that called? Called Sandra? Called a bit. Sandra, I'm asking you. Bit, Sandra, are you there? No. Are you able to hear me?
No.
What about others? Vidur, can you hear me?
Bit.
Yes, ma'am.
Then Sandra. So the smallest unit of memory is called a bit. A very important term in computer. Smallest term. So we know that computer language is binary language. That means machine language, or call it as, it knows only the language of electricity. So we use a low pulse, high pulse. A low voltage, high voltage pulse we are using to store everything. Everything related to voltage pulses. And we are using magnetic type of memory to store all the data. So here a bit means it can be either a low voltage or a high voltage. A bit means either a low voltage, we will denote it as zero, or a high voltage, we'll denote it as one. So a bit means either zero or one. That means suppose we are telling that, suppose I'm telling that my RAM has 1 bit of memory space. What is the meaning, Emmanuel? My memory has 1 bit of space. 1 bit, not gigabyte, not megabyte,
very,
1 bit.
Very poor.
Very poor. So what are the different things you can store? We can store?
Nothing.
Useless. Nothing. 1 bit memory storage means, no, it is not nothing. Either you can store a, like this, a 1 bit memory means this space, suppose. This for example, 1 bit. Either you can store, Achyut, either you can store?
Zero. Or one.
Or zero will go and either you can store one. That is the meaning of your memory has 1 bit memory space. Understood? Emmanuel.
In the, yes, ma'am.
So you can't say nothing. You can store one data at a time, that is 1 bit. One bit means either it can be a low voltage or it can be a high voltage.
High voltage.
So that is why it's called binary language. We are using only two things. One is low voltage, another one is high voltage.
High voltage.
Okay, that is why it is called binary. What is the number system that we are using? What is the number system that we are using in our normal life? Are we using binary number system?
No, international.
1, 2, 3, 4.
International system.
Decimal number system we are using. What is the meaning of decimal? How many numbers you are using? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So how many numbers?
10.
10 numbers. That is why it is called decimal number system. Here computer knows only two numbers. Either it is a low voltage or high voltage. So we are using how many numbers? I mean CPU, the computer using how many numbers? Two numbers. So it is called binary number system. Clear? If you are using 8 numbers, then what is that number system called? Any idea? Meghna? 8 numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8 numbers.
No.
No idea. It is called octal number system. There are these kind of number systems are existing in computer, but basically the main number system is binary. Octal number system is there and hexadecimal number system. What is hexadecimal number system? Atul? Hexadecimal?
I don't know.
Hexadecimal. What is this hexa?
Nine.
Once again, who said nine? Hexa means hexadecimal. It is, yes, six. Hexadecimal means 16 numbers. 0 to 15 you are using. That number system is called hexadecimal number system. So basically you have binary and you have octal, decimal and hexadecimal number system we are using to represent any data. So the next thing is, so it is 1 bit means that is the smallest unit of memory. Then you have So what is a byte? What is a byte? Hana, the board, it is the, what is a byte? Hana, I'm asking you. Unmute and say the answer. Unmute. How many bits? Again, if you are using headphone, just keep your mic near to your mouth and talk.
8 bits.
8 bits. 8-bit is called a byte, and it is, you have to be very careful when you write byte. The B should be capital letter. 1 byte. So in short form, we will write one byte. How many bits, Muhammad Adim? How many bits?
8 bytes.
Unmute and say.
8 bytes.
Muhammad Adim, I am asking you. How many bits? 8 bits. Isn't it? So, Nevin, tell me, which is the smallest value that you can store using 8-bit? Smallest value? Yes. In binary language, Nevin? Smallest value using 8-bit. 1-bit means you can have either 0 or 1. That is clear? What about 2-bit? I have 2 bits of RAM. What is the meaning? What are the different possible values? Ashwin.
Zero, 0.
Yes. What is the lowest value that you can store? 2 bits means you can have two spaces.
0 and 0.
Okay. 0, 0 is the first combination. You can store a low voltage.
0, 1.
Yes.
0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1.
These are the possible combinations. So how many possible combinations? 1, 2, 3, 4. That means 2 bits means 2 raised to 2. Okay. So 4 combinations. Now my question was 8 bits. Now Nevin, you tell me, what is the smallest value that is possible using 8 bits?
Smallest value. 0, 0, 0, right?
Nevin.
Eight raised to two.
Yes, 8 bits. I can't hear you. Are you saying something?
8 raised to 2.
8 bits. So what is the smallest combination? I mean, what is the first combination that you will get? How many zeros?
0, 1.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 bits. 8 zeros, the combination.
Yeah.
This many memory space. 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. What is the next combination? Gauri. So happy, it seems. Now tell me the answer. Next combination. In the ascending order. So you can store 8 low voltage pulses then.
0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1.
Okay, understood.
Yeah.
Next combination. Can you use 2? You can't use 2 because you can use either 0 or 1. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Next one.
1, 1, 1, 1, 0.
0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. Then next one is In this way, it will go till where, Krishna Chandran, till where it will go, like this.
One,
how
one,
much value?
One.
One?
Zero, zero.
Last value, okay. One, one, one.
Eight.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Eight ones. That will be the last value. So how many values, how many data can be stored in this? So my RAM has 1 byte of memory capacity. That means how many data? What is the amount? How much data I can store? Dear. 1 byte of memory. We have seen that 1 bit of memory means either you can store 0 or 1. That means only one storage space. 1 byte. 1 byte means 8 bits. So what are the possible combinations? How to calculate? Math students. Aditya Raj. What are the possible, all the possible combinations? Tell me the number.
Number.
Two numbers, 4 combinations. 2 bits, 4 combinations. Isn't it?
8 raised to 2.
8 bits, it will be?
8 raised to 2.
2 raised to?
8.
2 raised to 8. 8. Okay. 2 is the base. 2 is the number system, 8 is the number of bits. That is how you will calculate. 2 raised to 8 combinations are possible. That many data you can store in a 1 byte RAM. Now that is clear, everyone? Any doubt about this? Any doubt in this byte and bit? How the values are stored, data is stored in the memory. Any doubts, Anna?
No, ma'am.
Clear. Mm-hmm. Sharath?
No, ma'am.
Understood or you did not understand? Okay. So, then we have the different combinations. Nowadays, the data memory space is coming in GB and MBs and GBs and TBs. So you can't always write bytes or bits. So what you will do, Vidu? We have another unit. It's like this. That is, one nibble is equal to 4 bit. But this 4 bit thing we never use. Only for the theory purpose, we are studying this nibble. One nibble means it is, Meenakshi? 4 bits. 4 bits. So how many combinations are possible? Meenakshi. If it is 4 bit, what is the starting value?
0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0.
Then 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. It will continue like this till 1, 1, 1, 1. So combinations are 2 raised to?
4.
4. So that many combinations you will get. So that is one nibble. Now, then 1 kilobyte is equal to 1 KB is equal to 1024 bytes. When you write capital B means it is byte. When you write small b means it is bit, it is not bytes. Either you can write in this way or you can write 1 kilobytes directly. You can write bytes is equal to 1024 bytes. So there is a difference here. 1 kg is equal to how many grams? Donna?
1
1 kilogram is equal to yes
1000.
In our normal life, here the change is like 1000, but when it comes to computer, it is 1024. There is no 1000. It is always 1024. Clear, Srihari? Again smiling. Understood, Srihari?
Yes, ma'am.
Srihari.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So, 1 kilobyte is equal to 1024 byte. That is 2 raised to 10 byte. Then 1 megabyte is equal to 1024. You can read at least, right? Should I call your name for reading? 1 kilobyte is equal to, 1 megabyte is equal to 1024 kilobyte. Then 1 gigabyte is equal to 1024 megabyte. Then 1 terabyte is equal to 1024 gigabyte. So Emmanuel told that the normal our memory capacity is 2 GB, 3 GB, 4 GB, right? RAM, isn't it, Emmanuel? Yes or no? Isn't it, Basil? 4 GB. Nowadays we have a 4 GB RAM. So how many combinations are possible? You can just imagine. How many bytes? 1 GB means how many bytes? Basil, can you tell me how many bytes or how many bits 1 GB means? How many bits? It's pure mathematics. How many bits? Are you a math student?
No, ma'am.
No. Any math student? Grishma?
Yes, ma'am.
How many bits? 1 GB is equal to how many bits? Just see this and tell me how many bits. Mute others. Yes. Now, Shivani, tell me how many bits? Just write the reverse. 1024. Into, if you multiply with 1024, it will become MB, right? Then into
1024 into 8.
So you don't have to calculate like this. So that many combinations are possible in the memory. That means when it comes to 8 GB memory means that many storage is available. 10 GB means that many storage. So hope you understood the memory concept. Nowadays we have many other things, that is giga, the spelling is wrong, G-I is giga, the spelling is wrong. Tera, hard disk capacity is coming in nowadays, it's tera. Terabyte means 1024 GB is equal to 1 terabyte. Again, we have petabyte. We have learned about supercomputers. The supercomputers, they will have peta and exabyte. So after 10 years, you can see your computer hard disk capacity, or after 5 years, your hard disk capacity will be 1 exabyte and all. After 20 years, it will, another range will come. So that much fast this computer technology is, it's growing, okay? Understood? That this is a very important topic. This is a very basic topic of computer memory. So if someone asks you what is the memory capacity, how it is calculated, so you just imagine your RAM as a room. In that room, how many things you can store? So when the RAM size increases, your memory, your room size also increases. So if the room is big, you can store that many things in that room, isn't it? Hadi? Yes or no, Hadi?
Yes.
Yes. So next topic you will see is speed. What is the speed of a normal computer? How will you say speed? Sharath, you are using laptop, right?
Yes, ma'am.
The first day I told you, I gave you as a homework, and you were there, right? You were there, that first class.
No, ma'am, I wasn't there.
No, you thought it's IP is a different class, computer science is a different class. So, Sandra, I have told you to, that day I told you to do a homework, find the speed, isn't it?
First
Sandra,
class.
Hello. Say something.
Ma'am, first class
and
second class
and all that. Not audible at all. Adul, what was the speed when you checked your laptop speed or your computer PC speed? Adul, Adul KK.
2 gigahertz.
What is a computer speed?
2 gigahertz.
And I'm not able to hear it. Whatever
2
you are
gigahertz.
Saying. Yes? 2 gigahertz. Okay, very good. And with that microprocessor, there was another name was written. What was that? 32-bit, 64-bit. Have you seen that?
Yes.
So what is that? 32-bit operating system. What it 64-bit processor, not operating system, 64-bit processor, isn't it? So
yes.
I will show you this here, the computer systems. This PC. Properties. So you can see what is the processor given? Intel Core i5 processor 8400, CPU at 2.80 gigahertz, and RAM is 4 GB RAM, and system type is 64-bit operating system x64 based processor. Actually it is 64-bit processor, it's not actually operating system, 64-bit processor. What is the meaning of 64-bit? Again the question, what is the meaning of 64-bit? It's something related to memory, right? Reina, yes or no? A bit, byte means something related to memory.
Yes ma'am.
Now how it came here for the processor? You know, a CPU has one thing, extra thing that is called, you have studied in smaller classes, a CPU consists of arithmetic logical unit and control unit, isn't it? ALU and CU. ALU will do all the arithmetic operation, control unit will do all the controls, isn't it?
Yes ma'am.
Yes or no? Yes.
Yes ma'am.
So, one more thing is that is called it is called registers. What is that called? Registers. Am I audible to you? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So in CPU, there is a special memory that is called as register. Okay. So CPU cannot process all the things which is taken. It has to go and take from the RAM and it has to process. It's very difficult. So whenever you buy a CPU, you will get another extra thing with the CPU that is called a temporary place where there can store all the things and do the, see, suppose CPU is near to CPU. So RAM will be situated in somewhere and the data time from the processor to the RAM, it takes a lot of time. So what happens is if it tries to take everything from the RAM, it will take a lot of time. So CPU has a special register so that all the things, whatever we needed that much time, at that time itself, CPU needs, it can take from the register and it can process and it will keep it back to the register. And who will take from the register? Who will take? Sharad, who will take from the register?
I don't know, ma'am.
Who will take? Any idea, Grishma? Who will take? CPU kept everything, CPU processed and kept it in the register. Who will take it? Operating system. Operating system will take from the register and it will give it to the respective, whether it is input device, output device, wherever it is needed, it will provide it. That is why operating system is called as interface between the computer and user. To user, everything is provided by operating system, but the processing is done by CPU. So that register has a certain capacity. That capacity is given as, in that computer you can see 64-bit operating system, 64-bit processor. That means at a time, the CPU can process 64-bit data. It can address. It can take 64-bit data at a time and it can process. So which is better, 32-bit processor or 64-bit processor?
64.
Nowadays we can have 128-bit. So the speed will be very high. When the register increases, see, we have a room and suppose from the hall the room is very, distance is more. Suppose we have another place or a cupboard. So what we will do is better to go to, my question is whether we will place all the things, frequently taking things in the cupboard, or you will go and keep it in somewhere else in the store. Where we will keep? Which is very near. In that place we will keep, right? What is the advantage of that? We can directly go and pick up the things. So it is difficult to go to some other store and far away place and take the things from there. The same thing happens here. CPU has a special memory that is called register, very near to CPU, with the CPU it is there. So what it will do is, whatever things which is provided by operating system will be kept in the register for temporary usage, and it will do all the calculations and it will keep back the result to the register. So it doesn't have to contact RAM for getting the things. So when the register capacity increases, CPU speed also increases. So it is the best one will be 128-bit, then 64, then 32. So older days, it is 1 year before we used to get a 32-bit processor. Nowadays, in all the systems, whenever you buy a laptop, you will get a 64-bit processor. And 128-bit processor are also available, but the cost will be more. If you want a high speed, then you have to buy a 128-bit processor. That is clear? What is this 4-bit processor? Okay, next day I will ask you the question again. So hope it is clear. If any doubt is there, you can ask me the next day, next class. Okay, then that's all for today. Take care. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Hi, ma'am.